understand. I don't like the way I look. I want to look like these models.
Why?
Because they're beautiful.
Well, so are you.
Oh, yeah? Well, show me one girl in here with this round face and these Charlie Brown cheeks.
In all the time that I've known you, I can't remember you ever looking in the mirror. You had this confidence in yourself, and I really liked that about you.
Come on, Sean. Everybody in high school has a mirror in their locker and checks each other out and only cares about how they look.
But up until a couple days ago, you never did. Your world got completely rocked when you hacked your hair off and saw that for 2 seconds you can actually look a little less than perfect.
You exist. You exist, and you're weird, and you get in the way of where I'm looking, so stop being weird and stop being happy. Nobody should be as happy as you. Stop being who you are, or I'm gonna put my foot in your weird, stupid face.
I'm gross, Manny. I look disgusting.
When was the last time you ate?
A couple of days ago. I feel good.
But you look sick. And the way you're talking, you might be sick.
I'm no tears. I don't want to ruin my makeup.
What was I kidding? I'll never get to model this dress.
Trish isn't pretty enough to be playing Sleeping Beauty. They should call the play Sleeping Not Beauty.
You don't really look like you.
You know, it's easy for you to spout your self-esteem BS. But look at me. Do you have any idea what it's like to be a teenage girl and to look like this? Of course not, because you're tiny. You're tiny and you're beautiful, and you've always been beautiful. This is why you stuck me with.
Seduced Scarlet doesn't suit you, dear.
I'm disgusting and fat and awful, and I don't deserve to live.
Stop.
It's kind of ridiculous. But my family, smart, driven, crazy overachievers, you know, and they look like they're smart. They don't look like me, which has its perks, except that my family treated me like I'm pretty. They expected nothing from me, ever. Never pushed me, never thought to. So I had to push myself hard. I didn't even tell them I was taking the MCAT after I'd aced them.
Maybe you still think of me as that dumpy junior high girl who laughed at all your jokes and gave you cuts in line and followed you around like some groupie.
This stretch sign is to die. Can I try it on? There's not that much stretch.
The other night I stuffed my face full of powdered donuts and then I cried myself to sleep. Listen, if you don't want to lose weight, that's fine, because that's your choice. But I told you that when I met you, that I couldn't fall for a fat person.
Is it me? Is it Sean?
How do I handle this? I don't know how to handle it.
handle this.
Why would someone say such mean things about me?
Oh, God, get this off.
Comedies where the perfect, charming Hugh Grant guy would bend over backwards for the woman that he loves. And I would think if I could have that, that I would be happy. And then I met you. And you were better than them. You were better than my wildest dreams. Just about my weight. It's just, I've got to get a handle on myself, on the weight and on all of it. And I need that more than anything right now.